Hello and welcome to the first LV County catch-up of 2014. It is raining, so that can only mean one thing. The LV County Championship season is about to get underway. Durham, home of the 2013 champions. Now, this competition provides the pathway to the England Test team. So over the coming months, you'll be hearing new names and see new stars emerge. And with a new season, brings new hopes and dreams for all 18 counties involved. All of them primed and ready to go. This month on the LV County Catch-Up, three of England's finest bowlers deliver their verdict on the season ahead and the winter just gone. Look out for some new fun features, including teammates going head-to-head in bat versus ball. And who will be able to master the sticky wicket in our slightly bizarre LV challenge. And this is what they're all playing for, the LV County Championship trophy. Durham have their hands on it for now, but there are eight other teams in Division One, all with their eyes on the prize. Durham have deviated from the formula that won them the LV County Championship by signing an overseas player. Australian bowling all-rounder John Hastings will join up with them after a stint in the Indian Premier League with the Chennai Super Kings. Division 2 champions Lancashire have recruited England one-day wicketkeeper Joss Butler from Somerset. And he'll be hoping a regular place behind the stumps in county cricket will earn him a place in the Test team. Notts have signed Australian pace bowler Peter Siddle, fresh from success in the Ashes this winter. Veteran seamer John Lewis has swapped Surrey for Sussex, while Aaron Finch joins New Zealand's Kane Williamson at last season's runners-up Yorkshire. Although Finch will specialise in the NatWest T20 Blast, he will represent the White Rose County in other cricket when Williamson is on international duty. Warwickshire are the bookies' current favourites, but it's tight with not much to choose between four or five of the counties. I'm joined here in the Graveney Lounge by one of the most fearsome bowling lineups you are ever likely to see. Steve Harmison, Simon Jones and Matthew Hoggard, between them, 500 test wickets for England, and they made up three quarters of the pace attack that famously regained the Ashes almost a decade ago now. But I'm going to come to you, Steve, first. In fact, you should be welcoming us here. This is your home ground, and what a season Durham had in 2013.
It did. You brought the weather with you, didn't you? It's gloomy and overcast, normal to this time. No, Durham were fantastic last year. Last year, there was a lot of people tipping Durham to get relegated, and, you know, The goal of the Ashes and trying to get in the Ashes group for someone like Graham Onions was a massive thing for Durham last year, especially here at the Riverside. This is a result pitch. Yeah, eight games at home, you will get eight results unless it rains for sort of 2.5 days. You always knew that Durham were going to win more games than they're going to lose, especially at home, and that's what won them the championship.
But don't you think it's a brilliant time to be a county cricketer at the moment?
Because
they've had such a torrid time in Australia. They didn't perform too well in the West Indies.
But I tell you what will happen. The same team, more or less often than not, the same team that performed badly in Australia, you stick that 16-player squad into the championships at the start of the summer, and I would imagine 14 out of the 16 will be the best players in the country for their counties. So that tells you that we had the best team there.
They were just all played.
But it is great for county players. They've got a new coach coming in.
Yeah.
Don't know who that is yet. So they've got somebody else to impress. They've got a lead into Sri Lanka to say, right, then if we're scoring runs, taking wickets, then we've got to have a look and a sniff of getting into there, because not one of the England players earned their right to be in that England shirt at the moment.
So you're predicting an explosive start. Simon, who do you think, apart from Durham, obviously they will be the defending champions, who do you think are going to be the main contenders this season?
Alex Sussex. I think they've got a lot of strength and depth there. They've got some quality bowlers. And I really like Steve McGoffin. I played with him at Worcester. He's a quality performer. He bowls in good areas. He bowls quick enough to nick people off. And in the batting, they've obviously got Joyce, Nash, and I really like the way they look. They finished third or fourth last year, but I think they can do a lot better this year. Knots are obviously there or thereabouts. They're a quality outfit, but they'd be disappointed with last year. But I really fancy Sussex.
What about you, Hoggy? Yorkshire's just picked by Durham. They were in it for most of the summer, weren't they? And ended up runners-up.
They were. I've got a very good feeling about Yorkshire at the moment, obviously. And again, they've made some very shrewd signings. I think with the likes of Brooks, Plunkett, who's had a fantastic England A tour, Lions tour, with Sidebottom as well, with Adil Rashid, who can bat and can bowl and take wickets. The amount of runs might be the issue for Yorkshire, but they're going to take 20 wickets. And the way that they ended last season and the way that Andrew Gale's got a good grip of the squad with Jason Gillespie, I think they could be right up there with the top, with Knots. You can't write Knots off with the players that they've got, but I like Yorkshire.
The members of cricket clubs are going to see the best players hungry to succeed. And I think the last time I can remember that happening was in 2005, when we all had about 5 weeks, 6 weeks. I played for Durham for 5 games, and I was desperate to be in top form for the 2005 Ashes start. And I think we all were. And I think if you look at the county cricket leading into that Ashes series, everybody that was in that England team was performing.
Just want to end on Division One by getting a name from each of you. Which Division One player do you see getting one of those test places that are up for grabs at the moment? Start with you first, Harmy.
Moen Ali.
Chris Jordan.
Oof. Who's the opening bat for Middlesex?
Sam Robson.
Sam Robson. I'm backing Sam Robson to get a gig.
Well, we'll be hearing more from the boys in just a moment. But first, a brand new feature where batters and bowlers go head-to-head in a game we've imaginatively titled Bat versus Ball. Two of Durham's rising stars, Graham Clark and Andy Ireland, are first up. So let's see whether it's the run maker or the wicket taker that come out on top.
My name's Graham Clark. I'm 21 years old. I'm a batsman and my buzzer sounds like this.
My name's Andrew Ireland. I'm 18 years of age. I'm a bowler and my buzzer sounds like this.
OK, so the rules are simple. First on the buzzers, answers first. If you are wrong, your opponent gets a chance to steal the point. Are we clear?
Yeah. Yeah.
OK, 10 questions, guys. Good luck. Here is question number one. Who was the leading wicket taker for Durham in the 2013 LV County Championship?
Graham Onions.
Correct. 70. Question two. Which Durham player has taken the most test wickets for England?
Steve Harmison.
Correct. 222. Question three. Which former England football captain was born in Chesterley Street?
Oh, no. I was going to say Alan Shearer.
No. You've got a chance to steal in here, Andrew. You could take the point.
No. Not a clue.
The answer was Brian Robson. Next question. What is the middle name of Durham batsman Keaton Jennings?
I lived with him for a year. Oh, Keaton. Oh.
Keaton nah. Something Jennings? It isn't nah, something.
Pass.
No.
Pass.
Andrew?
Don't know.
It's Kent.
Keaton Kent. KK, I knew it.
Question five. Who scored the most runs for Durham in the 2013 LV County Championship?
Scott Offutt.
You were sure about that, and you are correct. 1,022 runs. Next question. Which comic actor was born in Consett, Durham, and appeared in Johnny English and Mr. Bean?
Rowan Atkinson.
Correct. Question seven. What year did Durham first compete in the County Championship? Oh, I think that was Graham Jass.
1995?
No.
98?
No, 1992. Question eight. Name two Durham players with food as surnames. Andrew?
Onions and mustard.
Correct. Question nine. What is the name of the bread eaten in Durham traditionally served with ham and peas pudding?
Not a clue.
Andrew?
Not a clue.
Stotty.
Never heard of it.
You'll be inundated with it now. And the final question, how many times have Durham won the county championship? Oh, Andrew.
Three.
I told you that before.
Correct. Well done. By my calculation, that makes it 3-3. It's a draw.
Can't believe I drew with him. Well played. Well done.
Good sports both. Thanks, guys. So it finishes honours even in a hugely competitive contest, as it will be in the LV County Championship Division 2. Here are the teams who will be battling it out for promotion. Derbyshire, relegated from Division 1 last season, have added opener Stephen Moore to strengthen their batting lineup after his release from Lancashire. Following his successful loan spell last year, Essex have signed England spinner Monty Panesar from Sussex. Jack Rudolph joins Glamorgan on a two-year deal. A proven performer in county cricket with Yorkshire, the South African has over 16,000 runs in first-class cricket. Hampshire have recruited former Durham title-winning captain Will Smith and Mike Gatting's nephew Joe. And South African bowler Kyle Abbott, who took 7 for 29 in his only test last year, is their new overseas player. Pakistan off-spinner Saeed Ajmal, the top-ranked one-day international bowler, is set to make a return for Worcestershire. While relegated Surrey, despite no new faces in their lineup, are the bookies' favourites, with Leicestershire the rank outsiders. So, Hoggy, Leicestershire finished bottom of the pile, no wins in 16 fixtures. Tell us it's going to get better this season.
I'd like to tell you it is. It's got to, hasn't it? They can't get any worse. But again, shrewd signings, not so many. Are we going to get 20 wickets? I think the only hope that we've got is if we can manage to play on some turning wickets, and we've got Jigar Naik and James Sykes that can come in and take wickets. I think it's not a quick fix. They've got to have a three-year plan, and at the moment it's going to be a hard slog for them.
What about Glamorgan, Simon? Disappointing season, eighth place finish. Promotion realistic for them maybe this season? What's going on behind the scenes there?
I don't see why not. I've played there for a couple of years, and I've seen the squad is coming through, and there's a lot of talent there. There's young lads like Andrew Salt are coming through. David Lloyd, Ben Wright's been started performing over the last couple of years. But for me, it's the bowling, is Michael Hogan. Dean Costco's got wealth of experience. Jim Allenby's been on fire for the last 2 or 3 years. So I think if they can just get it together, I think they could really push for a place.
You're probably in the second division. In the grand scheme of things, you're looking at one place to go up. Surrey should walk away with it. Graham Smith, you know, Kevin Peterson for 6 games, he will get 400s in them 6 games if he plays. You know, they will get Surrey promoted. Kent have got an outside sniff, they've made some good signings. You know, you're going to have Treadwell for most of the season. You've got Doug Bollinger, who is a good international bowler, Mitchell Clayden, who's left Durham and gone down there. And then you've got the evergreen Rob Key and Darren Stevens. Who will get?
Who will get?
They'll get a thousand. I would imagine they'll get 1,000 runs. And Keezy being captain now, it could be the outside bet to maybe nick that second spot. And then, you know, who knows? But I think if a team can start winning matches and win 5 or 6 games and get on Surrey's shirt tails, it'll be difficult to stop. I mean, obviously, Derbyshire are in there as well.
So perhaps more Surrey and Kent for you. What about you, Hoggy?
Yeah, obviously Surrey. Derbyshire's got a point to prove. I think Chris Grant's come in and put in a very good structure. He's paved the way for how county championship should be, well, team should be run. He's treating it as a business. He's putting a lot of time and effort and money, and made sure that the structure, the coaching's right down to the grassroots. He's got people that are passionate about the clubbing, so I want to see Derby do well.
It's pretty open though, isn't it?
Sure. Yeah, there is. It's Surrey plus one from probably four or five teams.
What about players who could potentially break through to that test team? As we were discussing earlier, it is an England team in flux. There are places up for grabs. Everyone can stake a claim in Division 2.
James Vince for me. James Vince. I've played at Hampshire for 2 years and I've never seen anyone hit the ball as hard in my life. But the time he's got, and he's got a great manner about him on the field. He's very calm. And for a young lad, he's played some match-winning innings. All he needs to do is go from the one-day game and transfer his form into the four-day stuff, and I think he'll be pushing for a place.
Well, plenty of thoughts there about those with a bright future, but now three of our finest from the past, that's right, these three boys, agreed to play our new game, Sticky Wicket. Let's see how they got on. Mm-hmm. So these are the rules. It's a timed obstacle and relay course. The players have to negotiate these hurdles and poles, all the while juggling a ball on a bat. When they get to the wicket at the end, they have to swap over with their teammate, who will then negotiate the course all the way back. If they drop the ball, there's a 5-second time penalty. If they miss anything out, it's 10 seconds.
Hi, I'm Matthew Hoggard, and I'm a rabbit in headlights.
Hi, I'm Steve Harmison. I'm very much retired.
I'm Simon Jones, and I'm unemployed at the moment.
Gentlemen, get ready. 3, 2, 1, go.
Oi, dainty.
That's rapid.
Good speed, Hoggard, good speed.
Why have you done that to me now?
Come on, Jonesy.
It's a lot tighter than I thought.
You should be on Strictly with them feet.
Very good.
Go on,
Ham. Harmison. Agile for a big lad. Agile for a big lad.
Go on, Ham.
Come on, Harmison. Oh, oh, no!
First drop. Come on, Army.
Yay!
43 seconds. It's all right, that.
They want it.
So then, boys, 43.6 seconds, but with a 5-second penalty. Happy with that?
I think it's going to be beaten.
I'm just happy it's over.
I don't think I hit the ball in the middle of the bat that many times in my career.
So, just Team England on our leaderboard so far with what doesn't look like a particularly speedy time, but you never know. Keep watching every month to see how the counties fare against our England legends. Well, one thing's for certain, there are going to be plenty of talking points this summer. And for those on the fringes and for those battling to keep their place in the test team, the action is about to start. Newly promoted Lancashire travel to Trent Bridge for the opening match, while the other season curtain raiser sees Sussex entertain Middlesex. The rest of the team start their campaigns a week later, with Durham beginning their defence at New Boys North Hants. Equally intriguing fixtures set the ball rolling in Division 2. Simon's old side Glamorgan will take on Surrey, while Leicestershire will be hoping to break their duck early, although relegated Derbyshire will prove a stern test. Essex, Gloucestershire and Kent begin their campaigns 7 days later. Right, that's it for our season preview. Don't forget you can follow us on Facebook and Twitter to get the heads up on the next LV County catch-up. But for me and the boys, it's goodbye for now.